Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, we have a slight delay to the CRS-21 launch as well as some other standard SpaceX bits. As always, it's then over to Boca Chica with infrastructure and Starship, including even more delays with SN8 still sitting on the pad. Let's head straight in and get up to date. On Thursday, SpaceX tweeted that they'd completed the static file for the launch of CRS-21 on December 5th with 40% favourable weather. Then, yesterday, Saturday 5th, they tweeted that they were standing down due to poor weather in the recovery area. They added that they would be targeting the launch today, Sunday 6th at 11:17am EST or 4:17pm UTC. In addition to their tweet on Thursday, SpaceX tweeted about the booster that will fly the CRS-21 mission. The booster, known as B-1058, previously flew Crew Dragon Endeavour with Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley, as well as the Anisys 2 and a Starlink mission. The National Reconnaissance Office posted a tweet about the launch of the NROL 108 mission. They said that it was now targeting no earlier than December 17th. Something else to share, Shane Kimbra, a member of the Crew 2 mission, posted this image on Twitter. This is the mission patch for the Crew 2 Dragon launch next year. Moving on to the stuff happening in Boca Chica, a whole load of work has been going on at the orbital launch pad area. Here's a view of the new structures they are currently building over by this area. Also in the launch area, engineers have been working on the suborbital launch mount at Pad B, possibly for SN9. We've seen the shipping containers that have been placed to extend their wall. Now they've been working on getting ready to attach more metal sheets. In the launch area, a crane was seen attaching to and lifting a new shipping container. Over in the production area of the facility, the newly built high bay is continuing to be worked on as they get closer to completion. In another area of the SpaceX facility is the old Gaswell lot, where even more work was seen going on. It's still not clear what they might be getting ready to do there. Next up, we have a few bits of Starship here and there, starting with some new nose cones under construction. This nose you see in front in the fabrication tent also has some mounts for canards. One of the new nose cones we are seeing being constructed was also moved out into the yard. On the sleeving mount, a new upper bulkhead was seen ready to be sleeved. A two-ring stack was seen moving near the super heavy ring stacks as it was moved into a tent. By this collection of booster barrel sections, a new, partially built Starship nose was spotted. The yard is teeming with activity, and here is a section that was seen being moved. Plus, there was another stack that was also moved elsewhere. Most of you will know, but if you don't, this nose cone was from the very first full-size Starship. Before they started the serial numbers, they built this for the Mark 1 prototype and the tank popped during a pressure test. After having sat in the yard for many months, this old nose was seen having its cannons removed. We have some new pieces delivered for prototypes with some bulkhead caps seen arriving. As well as that, there were more deliveries containing body flaps for future Starship prototypes. We now have some bits to look at for SN8, starting with testing. Wednesday, SpaceX didn't perform a static fire, but they did do a wet dress rehearsal. Michael Baylor tweeted on Thursday, SpaceX is now targeting Monday for Starship SN8's test flight. The temporary flight restriction for Friday's attempt has been pulled. A new TFR will have to be published for Monday, which is the next possibility per road closures. He also tweeted, some sort of testing remains possible on Friday. The road closure remains live, unclear exactly what, perhaps a static fire, but certainly no flight without the TFR. We have some interesting news about the altitude for the test flight, which has changed. Somebody tweeted the long-awaited flight of Starship SN8 won't be to 15km anymore. It'll be to 12.5km in altitude. Michael Baylor also tweeted saying, have also heard that this is the case. We are seeing a minor refinement of the flight profile as the teams get closer to the launch date like we saw with Starhopper. With the SN8 flight still very soon, the FAA has posted some new temporary flight restrictions after pulling the previous ones. We have TFRs for today the 6th through to Tuesday 8th, although I doubt the flight will be happening today. Looking at the road and beach closures from Cameron County, we can see a primary closure of today. There's also another primary closure of tomorrow, which I expect will be for the 12.5km flight and possibly a static fire today. Back updates have also been added with Tuesday and Wednesday. Engineers have continued to work underneath this prototype in preparation for the flight. I really hope we get to see this machine fly in the coming days. It feels like we've been waiting so long. Whilst SN8 is waiting for testing, so too is SN9 as it gets closer to being ready in the high bay. With all the Starships under construction, we have yet another prototype spotted with this first common dome section for SN16. Yep, serial number 16 already. Having already been sleeved with the common dome, the section was moved and a crane was hooked up to it. Then they flipped the ring stack into the correct orientation. I can't believe we've now seen SN16, I can't imagine what sort of flying they'll be doing with this prototype. To finish up the video, I like to include these awesome diagrams from Brendan Lewis. Here's the latest status of the Starship and Super Heavy prototypes. I always have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, for her time and dedication filming this amazing stuff. Not only that, but thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes to bring us great live streams and space coverage. I just want to add a little promo. If you didn't know, we have a Discord server where you can come and join a bunch of space fans. There's a link down in the description. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.